Now, staying with the car-related news, and a top official from Mercedes-Benz says fully automated cars will be commonplace on the world's roads in the next 20 to 30 years. Hwang Ji-hye sat down with the German automaker's CEO of research and development in North America for the inside scoop.
The new Mercedes-Benz E-Class. On top of the hedonistic delights that the German carmaker's bread-and-butter saloon provides, this new vehicle is also considered to be one of the smartest. Its driverless operation system, called Drive Pilot, enables the car to accelerate, brake, change lanes, and even bring itself to a complete standstill.
The state of Nevada has just awarded the E-Class the only vehicle with a license to do autonomous driving testing on normal roads. So the vehicle is already equipped with such an amount of sensors and intelligence that it could actually serve as an autonomous vehicle.
So in the race to build fully automated cars, the question is,
how has the direction of development changed or become more focused?
There is a new direction coming up, which is more the revolutionary approach, where you start from scratch to really be able to drive autonomously in every situation.
Nishroy says it's no longer about adding more sensors or cameras, but about how to get cars to think for themselves. While automated vehicles won't drink and drive or doze off at the wheel, they're still unable to deal with unexpected events on the road, which means they lack the ability to make decisions, or in other words, think like a human. Now, the name of the game is bringing the technology that people saw when Google's artificial intelligence AlphaGo defeated Go Grandmaster Isidore into cars. Given the challenge, major auto manufacturers are striking partnerships with IT giants in Silicon Valley, despite fears that these tie-ups might drag them down to being low-value hardware suppliers in the longer term. Nishroy adds that securing the technology won't be the sole obstacle to driverless cars roaming the streets.
So we have to discuss with the legislative authorities what is possible now, where should the limits be, what will be the way forward, who will certify these systems, who is the neutral body to say they are really safe.
So there are a good number of roadblocks ahead, but as technological development speeds up, Nishroy believes the idea of truly self-driving cars becoming commonplace is still in sight.
If you want to really go to a dealership and buy a car and say, with this car, I'm not going to drive anymore, I'm only going to take a ride, this is going to be in 2030 from now.
And by then, it's likely that machine learning and thinking robots may have changed not just the auto sector, but our everyday lives. Hwang Ji-hye, Arirang News.